Next, a look at a seemingly counterintuitive business model. Economics correspondent Paul Solman goes inside an American clothing company that has been growing rapidly while marketing itself as an anti-growth business. It's part of our weekly series, Making Sense, which airs every Thursday on the NewsHour.
Are you guys sitting down? Because this is pretty horrifying. Okay. Dog bite? Shark attack?
Seamstress Kathy Averett couldn't care less.
When I get something like this, I do my best to make it kind of special, you know? It doesn't look new, but so what? Okay, I don't look new anymore. It's okay.
Averett stitches for Patagonia, the outdoor clothing company, high-end enough to have earned the nickname Patagucci. Downstairs, the company's Reno, Nevada warehouse and distribution center sends its garments hither and yon, to be worn by rock and mountain climbers, skiers and snowboarders, surfers, trail runners, or folks who just want to dress as if they do all that stuff. And each day, some of those clothes make their way back to Reno, to what's billed as the largest clothing rehab facility in North America.
They mess them up and we fix them up.
Behind me are 55 people extending the life of our product for our customers.
Doug Freeman is Patagonia's chief operating officer.
We want our customers to invest in great product, and when it's worn out, we want to repair it for them.
It doesn't sound economical for the company.
I can understand why you'd say that, but the way we view it is that we want to reduce consumption.
That's what makes Patagonia so odd, a supposedly anti-consumption corporation. Since its founding in 1973, it's always had a so-called ironclad guarantee, including free repairs, but recently the company ramped up its promotion of that pledge with a cross-country worn-wear bus tour, biodiesel-fueled, of course, tailors reviving garments at stops along the way. And though it spends little on advertising, Patagonia donates more than twice as much to environmental causes.
We give away 1% of sales each year to grassroots environmental organizations around the world.
The company is always on message. As in a famous full-page New York Times ad, don't buy this jacket.
It seems oxymoronic.
It certainly does. In fact, sales are booming, up 25 to 30% a year since that ad ran. But we wanted to know, is this just a sales gimmick? So we went to the new Patagonia store in New York City's Soho district, which boasts its own repair center. And in keeping with the reduce, reuse, recycle ethos, features wood beams salvaged from the former Domino Sugar factory and marble counters reclaimed from the renovation of the Museum of Modern Art. Turns out customers like yoga instructor Kim Larkin buy into don't buy this jacket.
It's intriguing because nobody's saying that. Everyone wants you to buy their stuff.
But are you less or more likely to buy something once you've been told not to buy it?
I think I'm more likely to buy it.
Why?
Because it feels like it's against consumerism in some way.
So what's going on? Well, according to Patagonia, if you buy stuff that lasts and gets revived so it will last even longer, well, in the long run, less stuff will get made and consumed.
We hope our existing customers do indeed buy less, but we hope to attract more customers that are interested in our message to build the best product, to reduce our impact and cause the least amount of environmental harm.
The way you could really reduce the company's footprint is by not selling any product at all.
Sure. But if we can show, you know, the business community that we're successful, we think we're holding ourselves as a great example for how business can be done differently.
So you're trying to knock off all the competitors out there who are making throwaway products, essentially.
That's right.
So that's the message, and it's certainly working. 30-year-old Rich Daniels is an aspiring men's fashion designer who would like to emulate Patagonia's less is more philosophy.
I think this Patagonia campaign is definitely a part of a bigger movement, fewer, better things. I'm not interested in disposable fashion.
In fact, he was shopping for a Patagonia jacket to replace one his parents had bought him when he was 15.
But do you feel at all as if you're being kind of suckered? Don't buy this jacket and yet please buy the jacket.
Sure, I mean, their goal is to sell clothes no matter what it takes. But I know that I'm going to have something that's going to last me a really long time.
Could the company be accused of conning the customer?
District manager Betsy Pantazelos.
And in the end, there's more consumerism, not less.
I think not only can that be said, I think people have said that, but at the end of the day, this is really truly who we are, and we're trying to invent a different approach to economics and to consumerism, and that we recognize we just need to start having the conversation.
Okay, let's grant the company the benefit of the doubt. But how, in short-term, Wall Street-driven corporate America, have they gotten away with a long-term strategy? Nice. Founder Yvon Chouinard, whom we were unable to interview because he was fly fishing, told an environmental forum recently that because Patagonia is privately held, he's free to reject traditional corporate values.
The problem with a lot of public companies is that they're forced to grow, 15% a year. They're forced to show profits every quarter. There's not one public company that will voluntarily restrict their growth for the sake of saving the planet.
In fact, Chouinard has taken legal steps to try to prevent Patagonia from ever going public. But what's so curious to observers is that Patagonia, by voluntarily restricting growth, has fueled more growth.
So I am faced with this growth thing. We could be a $1 billion company in very few years, and it's not something I ever wanted or even want.
So don't buy this jacket? Yeah. Do you really need it?
The Worn Wear Truck's latest stop, a music festival at the Museum of Contemporary Art in North Adams, Massachusetts.
Taking care of business.
Yes, we are.
Renowned rock climber Timmy O'Neill is another Patagonia marketing ploy. Not a pitch man, but a brand ambassador.
It's not, hi, I'm Timmy O'Neill, buy this jacket. It's, hi, I'm Timmy O'Neill, get outside and experience wilderness.
And he seems to mean it, as does clothing rehab artist Kathy Averett.
I'm going to tell you the truth, okay? When I first started here, I was excited. I'm going, ooh, Patagonia, man, they got good stuff. I bet they got a good employee discount. But after I went on the Worn Wear tour, I've changed my way of thinking. I'm only going to buy what I need.
This is economics correspondent Paul Solman reporting for the PBS NewsHour from Reno, Nevada, where old clothes go to live another day.